and welcome to the Aragon Analytics channel. Today's video is not going to be just an unboxing. Honestly, I find those types of videos somewhat boring. But today I received a package from Oldowan Tools to Stay Sharp in Santa Fe, New Mexico. One of the things in regard to the knife hobby or interest in knives, one of the things for me is this constant search for a way to get a keener and finer edge, particularly for tactical blades, not so much for knives I consider primarily for EDC or outdoor use, but for a tactical blade, especially a non-serrated blade, I want to have the keenest and finest, sharpest edge possible. As those of you who are subscribed to the channel know, or those of you who come to the channel from time to time know, I basically, for the majority of my sharpening, I use a Ken Onion work sharp. And, you know, I've played around with it, and I think I've reached a point with that particular device where, you know, I can get a smooth, not just a shaving sharp, but a smooth shaving sharp edge on just about any knife that I put through it. But I've kind of been motivated by some videos that I've seen, not so much the Wicked Edge videos, but there's another YouTuber called Michael Christie, and he does hand sharpening, freehand sharpening, and gets blades, even blades with you know, like M4 steel, or, you know, really high carbide, or just really hard to sharpen blades to hair whittling sharpness, and he does it freehand. Now, while I don't have the patience to go through an entire freehand sharpening process, I wanted to see if there's a way to use a product that will enhance the edge that I'm getting on the Ken Onion work sharp. So anyway, we'll go ahead and get this package opened. We'll use this ultra shitty, ultra crappy, although everyone seems to love it, this 940-1 Benchmade in S90V. I freaking hate this knife, and that's why it's now relegated to use as a glorified letter opener, a $267 letter opener. So let's see what we got in the package here. Shipping list here. Now, as I said, I didn't go and get a Wicked Edge sharpener. What I did find online was this two-piece Wicked Edge strop system, or the strops, and what I basically wanted to do was get the leather strops and some diamond compound. This one, I believe, is, yes, 1.5 micron diamond emulsions. So you open up the box, we'll get rid of that. And we'll set that aside. And what do we have here? This is the poly diamond emulsion, which equates to 30,000 grit. This is the 0.5. And here we have the poly diamond emulsion, 16,000 grit. So this, okay, blue bottle is the 1 micron, red bottle is the 0.5 micron. And we'll get this joker open here. Falling all over the place, but that's okay. So as you can see, you have your 1 micron and 0.5 micron sides labeled. Get this joker opened up here. So these are essentially leather strops. Now they're supposed to be used in conjunction with the Wicked Edge sharpening system, which if you haven't seen it, basically there's a clamp in the middle and then these metal arms that extend out to either side. And if you can imagine, this is the blade. You essentially use this sort of motion. Your angle is set by these metal arms that go through, I don't know if you can see that with the lighting, through this hole in the strop here. And then you essentially, you know, you have a consistent angle as you work your way across the knife edge on both sides at the same time. So that's why it comes with two. Now, the goal for me with this diamond strop, or leather strop with diamond emulsion thing, is, you know, I've seen Michael Christie on his videos get just hair whittling. Literally, he can suspend a hair and basically slice or little curly sections up to 4 or 5 times off a single strand of human hair. I'm not thinking that that's the kind of edge I'll be able to get using this just freehand, but I'm hoping that I will be able to get a more fine and refined edge using this system. Now my plan at this point is to keep these from getting contaminated with each other. So what I'm gonna do is essentially, you know, I'll store these in separate plastic bags. And I think that for right now, what I'm gonna do is just put the, you know, 1 micron emulsion on this one and the 0.5 emulsion on this one, and just keep them in separate bags so that they're totally separate. Now if this works out really well, what I'll probably do is get another set of these for use as like a travel hone, so that, you know, when I'm traveling, I'll have a means to you know, just kind of, you know, touch up my blades, because obviously traveling with that Ken Onion and all the belts and all that's not a good option. So what I'm gonna do is off camera I'm gonna look over the instructions that came with the strops here. Okay, so it seems pretty straightforward. So I've opened up this is the 1 micron diamond emulsion. It's going to use like a couple little drops. Make sure that that's worked in completely here. And here's the 0.5 micron. We'll give this a little . So hopefully, you know, I don't know if I was supposed to off camera. I did shake the bottle somewhat vigorously. That doesn't seem to be quite enough. Oops. That doesn't seem to be quite enough, so we'll keep working that into the... My way of thinking right now is that I want to have a complete coverage. I don't want to touch the surface of these strops. I don't want to touch them with my hands. I don't want to apply too much force to them. Basically, I want to keep them as flat and pristine as I possibly can. Okay, so I've given the emulsion a chance to kind of dry out a little bit, and what I've decided to try to do some enhanced sharpening on is the zero tolerance 0452 CF in S35VN steel. This thing is already pretty darn sharp. What I plan to do is essentially give each one of these strops, I don't really know how many strokes each way I should be giving this thing on each on each strop type or on each emulsion type. So I'm gonna go with doing maybe 30 each way on each strop, and then give that that same medium, that magazine paper, draw the knife through it and see. Now you can tell it's already cutting that fairly smoothly, but what I'll do is I'll just run it through both of these strops and then cut through that same material, and you won't be able to tell there at home or wherever you are watching this, you won't be able to tell any difference probably. I don't imagine that the microphone I'm using is precise enough to give you an idea of how smoothly it's cutting, but as I cut through that paper, I should be able to tell if there's a higher degree of sharpness or not. So what I'm going to do now is essentially try and find where the bevel is, and then what I'm trying to do here is essentially put a higher polish starting with the 1 micron emulsion, and I'm not pressing down really hard. Essentially what I'm trying to do is with feel try to estimate where the bevel is, and then with really nothing more than the weight of the knife itself, draw it across there, and like I said, I'm not pressing down hard. Just by hand here, trying to, I don't want to go above or the angle that I have already sharpened the knife at, because I don't want to roll the edge over. That already looks like it's picking up quite a polish though. So, like I said, I'm basically just letting the weight of the knife blade itself might be applying just a little, if I'm honest, just a little very slight pressure. I'm wondering if I put enough emulsion on there. It seems like it's already wearing off. And I hope I'm not, after all the effort I put into sharpening this. Now, granted, the Ken Onion Work Sharp is not exactly a labor intensive method of sharpening a knife, but there is a degree of finesse involved in using it properly, maintaining the angles precisely, and I just hope I'm not screwing that up. because although it doesn't require a lot of muscling around, it does require a degree of fine motor skill and patience and attention to detail when you're drawing the knife through the work sharp. What I'm hoping I'm not doing is I hope I'm not ruining that really fine edge that I put on there now. So let's see where we're at now. We'll switch over to the 0.5 micron. And you know what? I'm going to actually wipe the blade down first so that I'm dealing with a different emulsion. I don't want to cross-contaminate anything, although I honestly can't tell you if that would really make a difference or not. Screwed that up. Let's get another piece of this magazine paper here. See where we're at with the sharpness of this blade. Well, folks, I gotta say, I just don't know. Doesn't really seem like much of a difference, to be honest. Try a different medium cut. So, magazine paper is one thing. Phone book paper is another. To me, the hardest thing to get a clean cut on is actually newsprint, because newsprint it's thicker than phone book paper, but it's more fibrous and more mushy, and for some reason seems to be much more resistant to cutting. Yeah, I don't remember this thing. Wow, okay. Yeah, alrighty then. Okay, little addendum to the video before I let you all go. I spent another 5 minutes or so on this particular edge. And I have to say, it is definitely sharper than it was before. Even going against the grain of this newsprint, these long, slow, deliberate drawing kind of cuts are much easier now. And I don't really have a lot of arm hair left to demonstrate. But it is shaving even the small, it's tree topping basically the smaller hairs on my arm now. And it's just, the degree of sharpness on this blade now is really kind of sick. It's wiping instead of it. It doesn't even feel like it's shaving the hair now. Basically, it feels like it's wiping the hair off of my arm. In addition to that, another blade steel that was giving me some trouble was the S110V. Now the S35VN on the Worksharp took a pretty serious edge. Now it's even more refined, even by hand. The problem I think I was having with the S110V and the Spyderco, I think it had to do with the enhanced wear resistance and resistance to grinding. And I think that by using this diamond paste, well, I don't think, I know that the degree of sharpness on this knife is now higher than that of the zero tolerance. Before it was the other way around. I could get the ZT sharper. I just couldn't seem to get the S110V. Oh my God. I wish you folks could feel this through the TV screen. How just effortlessly this, and you know, without any snags or rough spots, and with what precision these cuts are being made with this S110V steel. And I think that's really gonna really be the key for me for this stropping stuff, for the diamond emulsion compounds. It isn't gonna be so much for the S30V or S35V VN steels, which those are grindable, and those actually take a pretty sick edge on just the Worksharp. But the higher carbide steels like this S110V, I just would, no matter how much I kept grinding and grinding on that Worksharp, and then eventually it just started becoming more and more dull. And I think that has to do with the abrasives used in the belts on the Worksharp. I don't think now, looking back on it, when it comes to putting these really fine edges on these high carbide steels, I think you really need to go diamond. And I'm probably, you know, those of you who are more experienced are probably like at home saying, yeah, duh. But yeah, the difference in this knife, you know, prior to and after going on the strops with the diamond emulsions, it's really not a huge difference. This was already a sick, wicked, scary sharp blade. The difference now is it's just a little bit more so. It's slightly more refined. It's smoother cutting through the more difficult to cut materials. The real difference with the diamond emulsion going from 1 down to 0.5 micron is now that this S110V steel is just sick sharp. And you know, with the blade geometry of the military being an excellent slicer as it is, I had no idea that you could just by hand and by feel get that kind of edge on a piece of steel. I always assumed that it, you know, that degree of sharpness would require a consistent angle sharpener. So I guess I owe a big thanks to Michael Christie and his channel for giving me the inspiration to just give this simple, like I think it was like a $60 solution, a try. And what I've learned now is that when it comes to the higher carbide steels like the S110V here, I'm going to just basically get a rough, you know, a shaving sharp edge on them using the Worksharp, and then I'll go over to the 1 micron strops by hand, do about, you know, 2 to 5 minutes of stropping with the 1 micron, then go to the 0.5 micron, and then, you know, now this thing is just a frickin' madman. it's literally, I mean, I'm not even feeling that hair come off. The degree of sharpness on this thing now is just, it just beggars description and defies belief. I honestly, I'm starting to question whether, you know, whether the razor that I shave with is any sharper than this. So, you know, this, I hate to keep going on and on, but I'm so stoked because this, I was about to go, to Blade HQ and order an S30V, military because I just wasn't satisfied with the degree of sharpness I was getting with the S110V. And I guess I should have just paid more attention, done a little more research, because you know the answer is simply in the in these diamond emulsions and using a high quality strop. So anyway, thanks for coming by to take a look at this. I'm really excited about this, and I think, like I said, for your lower hardness, lower carbide steels, I don't think it's going to make that much of a difference. It made a slight difference in the S35VN. I don't think it's really going to make a huge difference in most blades. But in your S90Vs and your S110Vs, it really did just put a absolutely insane sharp edge on this thing. And I'm so happy and so excited. So thanks for coming by, and I'll look forward to seeing you all in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.